Let's look at the audit of tangible non-current assets, the fixed assets, still continuing with topic five, substantive procedures. So, the audit of tangible non-current assets, we are dealing with fixed assets, assets that stay in a business for a period longer than 1 year. So let's look at the key areas when testing non-current assets, the key areas that the auditor is supposed to concentrate on when testing tangible non-current assets. The first one is confirmation of ownership. The auditor has to confirm whether the assets belong to the entity or not. Then inspection of non-current assets. It can be physical inspection to see if maybe they say that this asset was bought, to see if that asset is really there. Then valuation by third parties. This involves like determining the value of current non-current assets after a particular period of time. Then the adequacy of depreciation rates. Yeah. Most non-current assets depreciate except for land. Yeah, so the depreciation rates. So those are the key areas that the auditor is supposed to concentrate on when testing non-current assets. Let's look at the financial statement assertions and then audit objectives. And the first one is existency. So here the objective is to ensure that all the assets that were recorded in the statement of financial position actually exist. If they recorded that something was acquired, maybe a tractor was acquired during the year, you make sure that that tractor is present in the organization, it is physically there. Then, if they record that maybe this particular land was sold, you have to confirm whether that land was actually sold by looking at maybe the agreement of sale. Then, like you make sure that everything that was recorded in the statement of financial position actually exists or took place. Yeah, that is the existence assertion. So additions, they represent assets that were acquired during the year. Disposals, they represent the assets that were sold or scrapped off in there. Then recorded assets represent those that were in use at the year end. Then the completeness assertion. This is to make sure that the additions and disposals that occurred in the year have been recorded. Like all the additions and disposals that occurred during the year have been recorded. And the balances represent assets in use at the end of the year. That's the objective. In case they ask for the objective of the completeness assertion when it comes to tangible non-current asset. So the objective is to ensure that all additions and disposals that occurred in the year have been recorded. Then the next assertion is rates and obligation. Rates and obligation, here the objective is to ensure that the entity has a rates to the assets that they purchased. If they record that the entity purchased land during the year, the auditor has to confirm that the entity has rights to that land, maybe by looking at the land title. Then obligations is to ensure that the entity is actually obliged to pay the liabilities that were recorded in the statement of financial position. If it was recorded that the entity got a bank loan of maybe 300 million, the auditor has to confirm whether that loan is correct, whether it took place, whether they really got the loan and they are supposed to pay it. That can be confirmed by looking at the bank agreements and then the terms and conditions and all that, and then to ensure that that loan was actually received. Another session we have is accuracy, valuation, and then allocation. So for this one, accurate, it's something that is correct. So it is to ensure that non-current assets are correctly stated at cost less accumulated depreciation. Remember, non-current assets are supposed to be recorded at their net book value. We get the cost minus depreciation. Then it's also to ensure that the additions and disposals are correctly recorded. Then for classification, it's to ensure that tangible assets are being recorded in the correct accounts. And expenses which are not of capital nature are taken to profit or loss. Then lastly is presentation, and this is to ensure that there is a proper disclosure of things relating to the cost of the tangible non-current assets, things related to additions, and then disposals are properly disclosed, the depreciation policies that we use, useful lives of the assets are disclosed, then if there are some assets held under finance leases that are also disclosed, yeah, all in accordance to the applicable accounting standards. So those are the assertions relating to tangible non-current assets. We have existency, completeness, accuracy, valuation and allocation, classification, and then presentation. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, like, comment, share with your friends. Let's catch up in my next video.